Hello. If you're a kid, this is what a full-size tennis racket seems to be like to you.
Yes, no wonder we're not winning at Wimbledon. This is the answer. It's called short tennis for kids. We'll be looking at it on This Morning after the break.
Look, it's not you I've come to see, Michael.
Well, you're not seeing anybody else.
Look, I just want to speak to Elsa. Hit me again if you like.
What's the matter?
The impact's a matter, that's what.
Well, there's not a problem there, is there?
Oh, yeah, just one big one.
Oh, they've not backed out so soon, surely.
Oh, no, they want to exchange contracts straight away.
Well, what's the problem then? Surely that suits us.
It did, till I found out who the mystery buyer was.
Sun Packaging has always been small and neat, so there's not a lot to throw away. It's the same with this handy little Lenore refill. So don't bin your empty bottle. Fill it with this and water to make a full litre. And all you've got to bin is this tiny little package, which means less waste in the environment. And also less cost to you. Fill the bottle, not the bin.
If you've ever thought of skimping on cheese slices, here's something every mum should know. Kraft sliced cheese is made with a pint of milk in every single pack. This much milk in every Kraft slice. Which means there's calcium in it for her too.
This will help you grow up like me.
It's quite an eye-opener, isn't it? Kraft sliced cheese. A pint of milk in every single Kraft pack.
This is a picture of me a year ago. My friends thought I was pregnant. That was before I lost 29 pounds in 11 weeks with Jenny Craig. I walked in, they were very friendly, somebody said hello, made me a cup of coffee, sat me down. When you think of weight loss programs and diets, it seems such a pain. Jenny Craig made it all so easy. I really like the pancakes. When I was overweight, I felt like hiding away. Now I just want to go out and have fun every night.
What are you waiting for? It's £4 per consultation. Call your nearest centre now.
If you like pasta for your dinner, add fresh cream. You're on a winner. Oi! Scream for cream. And when you serve tomato soup, just grab fresh cream and loop the loop.
Oi! Scream for cream.
Who'd like fruit salad?
Oi! Scream for cream.
There is a story about a high-up Russian official, let's call him Mr. Ivanov, who wanted only the best for his daughter's wedding. So he used his political influence to borrow the Tsar's priceless champagne glasses for the reception. The wedding was a great success until one of the guests made a toast. A traditional Russian toast. Mr. Ivanov, we're delighted to award you the Order of the McVitie's Home Wheat, a digestive with lavish chocolate adornment, because when you take the biscuit, it has to be McVitie's.
The Continentals like their furters, and Herta's one they really like. They like to grill them, it always thrills them. Go on, take a bite, cold in a salad, hot from the barbie. Microwave them, they're always out of sight. With baked potatoes, just heat them. They're really wild with rice, they make a feature on a pizza. Make hot dogs very nice.
Herta, fresh from the chilled cabinet, do the Continental.
World Cup Plus, tonight on ITV. Live at 7.40, the stage is set for England's new heroes to stake their claim on a quarter-final tie with Cameroon. First, they face Belgium, whose immaculate finishing proved deadly in the first round and makes them England's toughest test so far. Then, after news at 10...
SAS, break in.
Lewis Collins stars in Who Dares Wins. Stick with the winning side, tonight on ITV.
Well, now from family finance to tenants, here's Richard and Judy in This Morning.
Mm-hmm.
good morning. Well, welcome to Tuesday on this morning. It might be raining where you are, but the covers are off and they're up and running at Wimbledon.
But never mind the tennis. Stay tuned to this morning for food, finance, fashion and much, much more. Here's what we're lobbing over the net today. First on court, training hard and tipped for the top, have we found Britain's tennis stars of the future?
Also investing in the future is Fusion. That's a centre for young fashion talent where the main aim is getting the business game sewn up.
On another winning streak is our very own roving reporter, Patricia Murphy, who passes the finishing post of her Trans World Challenge. That's just after 11 o'clock.
And later we meet Family at War actress Coral Atkins, who's been fighting her own battles to save the children that she says have been to hell and back.
And where would Wimbledon be without these? Another instalment of Susan's Strawberry Delights, just after midday.
Well, not everything goes together like strawberries and cream, especially when it comes to relationships. When love sours, the lawyers lick their lips, don't they? And over 3 million couples in this country are going to break up or divorce this coming decade.
Yes, a new major research project at the weekend predicted that by the turn of the century, the family unit will be in fragments. But divorce means not just emotional turmoil, but also a financial nightmare. The cost of splitting up is the subject of this morning's phone-in with our family finance expert, Anne Ashworth. What are your legal rights? Phone us now on 051 555 1000.
Well, this is what it looks like for the next 100 minutes. But first of all, sad to say, British tennis has had little to cheer about since Virginia Wade hit the winning shot in front of the Queen back in 1977 to take the Wimbledon women's singles title. And as for the men, well, you've got to cast your mind back to Fred Perry's 3 victories in the 1930s. In fact, he told us on This Morning last week that it all comes in cycles and that Britain's young stars will one day shine again. And maybe the first glimmering of that is at Bisham Abbey in Buckinghamshire.
I came here 5 years ago. It was really to give you good coaching, which I lacked at home.
I don't think I'd really been able to afford it if I hadn't come here.
Well, I've come here really to try and progress to the international level, because we're the best players in the country at the moment.
Every match I play, I always go out with a positive attitude, going to win, not to do my best, to win every match, whoever I'm playing.
It's got to be a goal. You've got to aim for the top, really, to be number one.
My ultimate goal is winning Wimbledon.
The last time a British man won Wimbledon was way back in 1936. It was Fred Perry. And I sometimes think we tend to live with the ghost of Fred Perry.
Perry wins 6-3, 6-love, 7-5.
Well, the future for British tennis through Bisham Abbey is looking a lot brighter than it was a few years ago. I think that we were losing ground on our European rivals, let alone the world rivals, for many, many years. Probably for the last 20 years we've been falling further and further behind, and now we're actually starting to keep a pace with them, if not gain ground on them.
We're very, very keen for tennis 2 weeks of the year when Wimbledon's on, but it's jolly difficult to keep the enthusiasm going throughout the year, particularly when indoor facilities in Britain are still lagging. I think in Britain it ranks as somewhere 15, 16, 17 in terms of participation sports, whereas on the continent it would be 3, 4, 5, something like that.
In music, it's accepted, it has been accepted, that, you know, a talented musician can spend many, many hours developing themselves. In tennis, it's taking a while for that to take place.
Boris Becker, sure, has got all sorts of attributes which are very special, but a fantastic effort has been made to actually make him a champion as well. You know, champions are born and made, I think. I think one's got to look at it from both points of view.
Come on, Andy Rich, that's too slow. I want you moving much faster than that. Great get, that's super reach. Come on, I want to hear those feet squeak a little bit. Good stuff. That's it, great pickup. Okay, swap round now, you're going to hit some serves.
Everything's got to be positive. You've got to present yourself as a strong figure who's going to win and it's not going to be swayed by sort of bad luck.
I mean, you've got to be very physically fit. You've got to be very self-minded in attitude. And you have to be very sort of dedicated.
Well, I think I let situations get to me. I get too frustrated at times. And if I conquer that, then I think I could do quite well.
You just can't get frustrated because it doesn't win you matches, it loses you matches.
Now, the programme that we have here for the boys is about helping them to overcome loss of confidence, to avoid feeling anxious, to be able to control their emotions, to be able to concentrate better. They're the key psychological skills, really, for them. For some individuals, arguing with an umpire would cause them to lose control. And for others, the McEnroes of this world, it seems that for him to complain, to get angry, can have an advantageous effect on his performance. But he's a rarity. All players could improve their mental attitude. Even the best aren't perfect. And certainly it's an area where we've, in this country, have been a little slow to work on that specifically. And it's these young boys who are hoping, we're hoping we'll change the mould for British tennis players, and we'll actually be capable of fighting it out and with the best of them.
I think it's difficult for them to appreciate what they've got to do, both physically and mentally. And I think it's the same for everybody in sport, that they've got to learn and understand what they've got to do. And I think that is partly why I'm here and why I'm involved and what I can put over as well. I think that does actually help them. But the thing is, at the end of the day, these lads themselves are the only guys that will do it. And this is the thing that you've got to get over. We can guide them, but they've actually to go out in that court and do it themselves.
At 12, I went to my first tournament abroad in France, and since then I've been to Japan, Hong Kong, China, and all the European countries, Cyprus. And